Gopalkrishna Gandhi, forward and honor, respect of enemies. Our dear colleague, Sitaram Yechury, and Comrade Raja, our new General Secretary of the Communist Party. It gives me immense pleasure and sense of great pride in this special evening to recall the contributions made by former General Secretary of the Communist Party of India, Comrade Indrajit Gupta, an astute politician, an eminent parliamentarian, a committed Unionist, a steadfast first communist Indian Home Minister, of and above all concerned human being who engaged his entire life for the betterment of the human beings. In fact, he needs no introduction to the people of the national capital or to the politically active citizens of our country. Yet, I am duty bound to place a few words about him in this August house, assembled to mark the centenary of his birth. In fact, though the actual anniversary date fell on 18th March, we were forced to delay the marking of the day because of the general elections. He was born on March 18, 1919, in a family of distinguished civil servants, but he opted to serve the nation rather than follow his family elders and came to civil service as a candidate. After his schooling in Chennai, where his father was working, he graduated from St. Stephen's College in Delhi in 1937 and to went to England for higher education, where he joined the King's College, Cambridge University. During his student days, there he, like many other early communist scholars, got attracted towards the communist ideas. After obtaining a degree in economics, he returned to India in October 1940. Soon after his return, he joined the Communist Party of India. His conviction to the revolutionary ideology and scientific principles for the emancipation of the liberated people lasted till he completed his tasks. Impressed by his talents as an organizer, the party decided to send him to Calcutta to organize the workers there. It was among the youth workers that he initiated his trade union activities. With his successful experience, he went on to organize the port and dock workers of Calcutta Port and emerged as a successful trade union leader. He, with his organizational skills, ability to grasp the problems facing the workers and appealing personality, could easily become an accepted leader of the workers and local people. His proven ability and commitment to struggle for the cause of the working class that he invited from Calcutta was appreciated by one and all everywhere in the country. Finally, in 1980, he was elected to the General Secretary of All India Trade Union Congress. He led the Indian working class as the AQC General Secretary for 10 years. As the top post leader of the AQC, he was associated with World Federation of Trade Unions, WFTU. Trade unions and its leaders all over the world recognized him in a sincere friend, a committed leader, and one who believed in the widest possible unity of the working class. Soon, he was elected as the Vice President of the WFTU and later as its President. Let me now talk about my close working relationship with him in the 12th of Lok Sabha, where I was a member and he was the leader of the C.P.I. group. Comrade Indrajit Gupta was first elected to the Lok Sabha in 1980 in a by-election from Southwest Constituency in West Bengal and continued to be a member of the Lok Sabha till the very last, with the exception in between 1970 1977 and 1980. He was a member of the second and third Lok Sabha from 1960 to 67, representing Calcutta Southwest, fourth and fifth from Alipur, seventh and eighth Lok Sabhas representing Machine House, ninth and 10th, 11th and 12th Lok Sabha from 1989 to 1999, representing Midnapur. In 13th Lok Sabha, he was re-elected from Midnapur, being the senior most member. With the affable character, he was popularly known as the father of the house. He was also speaker pro tem for 10th, 11th, and 12th and 13th Lok Sabhas. For a period of 18 months, he was the country's home minister in the elected front governments. There was his major contribution in the capacity of the revival of the interstate council as provided in the constitution. The report of the electoral reforms that came to be known since then has covered the Indrajit Gupta report and the special initiatives he took for the Northeast. I would like to say that it is during this period that freedom fighters conscience, which were printing for a long time in Telangana, in Goa and other places, that were cleared. He proved himself to be a parliamentarian par excellence who scrupulously followed the rules and procedures of the house. His steadfast commitment to his ideology and belief never came in the way of his listening with patience, even those with whom he differed. At times, he appreciated their views. During his illustrious parliamentary career, Comrade Indrajit Gupta also left his imprint on strengthening the parliamentary committee system in our country. He always spoke with knowledge on national and international developments. His interventions in the House, in fact, unveiled the policies and programs of the party vividly and eloquently. Just before becoming the Union Home Minister, Comrade Indrajit Gupta was elected in 1990 as the General Secretary of the Communist Party of India, a position which he held till 1996. Again in 1968, he was elected as the Secretary of the National Council of the Party. And in 1988, he became the Deputy General Secretary of the Party. His 37 years of service as a Lok Sabha member will be remembered for generations to come, both inside and outside the Parliament. On his death on February 29, 2001, the President of India, K.R. Narayan, paid his tribute to the personal character that Comrade Indrajit Gupta, saying, quote, "A brilliant and veteran parliamentarian and a true leader of the people." So Indrajit Gupta remained the vanguard of the communist movement in our country and fought for the rights and the freedoms of the people, especially the utter villages, till the very end of his life. He enriches parliamentary proceedings and debates with his passionate exposure of public cause, his eloquent oratory, and subtle and penetrating wit. In his long and eventful life, marked by the dissolving simplicity, uncompromising integrity, and honesty, Sri Gupta earned the affection and respect of all people who came into contact with him, cutting across the political parties and ideologies. Thank you very much. Now,